all set?
I'm gonna go ahead and call the May 3rd, 2023 Public Works meeting to order. Before we get started, I just wanna have all of us give a moment of silence to our colleague Jeremy Zellwin and the loss of his son Cole. Cole passed away this morning, so if we could all just please keep the family in our prayers, and if we could just do that for a few minutes silently. Okay, thank you. Okay, roll call please.
Mr. Khan.
Here.
Mrs. Meany.
Here.
Mr. Schumitz.
Here.
Okay, changes to the agenda, there are none. There are no announcements. We do have a set of minutes we need to get approved.
I'll make a motion to adopt the minutes from April 5th, 2023.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Roll call please.
Mr. Khan.
Yes.
Mrs. Meany.
Yes.
Mr. Schumitz.
Yes.
Okay, moving on to referrals. This was a referral from the Planning Commission. This is a correspondence received from Larry Apple, Hawthorne Golf Estates, 27840 Aurora Road, requesting to be removed from the inactive agenda and placed back onto the active agenda. There's a revised subdivision plan, which was submitted March 31st, 2023. So, you're back. So I hear we have some changes going on. I do believe that planning referred this, you know, to Public Works. Obviously, the big change here is gonna be the sanitary sewer now that originally was going to go to Bedford Heights. You now have changed that, and you now would like it to come to Solon. Obviously, this is the group and our committee, you know, that kind of deals with the infrastructure part of things going on with the city. So I don't know if you want to come up and just briefly, I mean, I think we all have all the information, but if you want to just kind of briefly give us a little bit of a, and just state your name and address for the record, please.
Sure, thank you. Lauren Sample, 25250 Rockside Road, Bedford Heights, Ohio, representing Hawthorne Golf Estates. As you indicated, the principal change is the change in the sewer line, which is now proposed to go from our subdivision directly to Hawthorne Parkway North, tying into the sewers operated by the City of Solon. So to do that, we need to reverse the previous approval we had. We have to change the facility planning area by NOAACA. We've discussed the application. NOAACA has preliminarily reviewed the application, and they are prepared to review it formally. We need to submit it in June.
Okay. Okay. I do have a few questions. I mean, obviously, previously you were going to have the flow go out onto Richmond Road.
Correct.
Okay. So now we're looking that we're going to come out the private street that you have going in and then going up to Aurora Road. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. And then there's also another part of on the Metro Park there that will be part of that. That's the red line here. That's, I don't know, document, can you put that?
I don't know if this is shown on the image or not.
Well, the one.
The main sewer goes north.
Yeah, but.
For the subdivision, there is a red line going south.
And what is that for?
That is to serve the expansion of the restrooms.
Okay.
The Metro Parks is building in conjunction with their purchase and development of the park on the adjacent site. Okay. There is no sanitary sewer in those restrooms now.
Right,
okay. So the sanitary sewer will serve those restrooms.
Okay, so that red line, so that also obviously is gonna come now too.
Yes, that will also be on Hawthorne Park.
Okay, okay. Well, it does sound like you obviously still have the NOAACA situation to work out. I mean, we really, and from what I've been advised, and trust me when I say this and all of you know this, you know, I'm trying to move this forward. We want to move this forward the best we can.
We appreciate that.
You know, that being said though, we still have to do what's right. These people that are going to live here are going to be residents of Solon, whether you're a public or private development. You know, we want to do it right. We want to make sure it's right. That being said, It sounds like until you can quote-unquote undo the agreement with NOAACA and Bedford Heights, you know, it's not like you can't put any shovels in the ground or do anything until that part is taken care of, if I'm understanding myself correctly.
Correct. We want the approval today, though, so we can go step by step. So this is the first step.
Well, what sort of approval do you want?
Approval of the sewer line going north on Hawthorne Parkway to tie into the Solon sewer. And I think pursuant to the report by the city engineer, there is some language the city council has to approve to reverse the facility.
Right. Well, I was going to say, for sure tonight, we can get this referred back to council so we can amend the 208, you know, to have it coming to us. I mean, that those are things that we can do. And, you know, my plan was to refer you guys back to planning with, you know, based on the engineering memo.
Correct.
You know, that's what we can do tonight. I think that's basically what you're asking us to do is to, you know, we need to do these steps. Obviously, council needs to, you know, we have to do that 208 plan, you know, and say, okay, we're going to refer it back. We're going to, you know, amend the 208 plan so the sanitary sewers come back to Solon.
Yes.
John, is that good? Is that, I mean, I got to do it because that's what our legislation was previously.
So in doing that, can the Planning Commission still give us preliminary plan approval conditional upon the NOAACA 208 plan?
I mean, I don't want to speak for the Planning Commission. I think, you know, for me, I would rather...
They can start working on it.
Yeah, I mean, certainly you can start working on it, but I mean, as far as, like I say, starting shoveling, I don't think you're going to be able to do that because I think, and John or Paul, if you want to speak up here, John.
Well, we understand we cannot start construction, but we will, you know, it is our intention that the Planning Commission, which I believe is May 9th, you know, for us, approval of the preliminary plan so we can go keep the procedure going. We have not yet reviewed, you know, or received approval of the construction plans. We understand that.
Yeah, but now that you have this happening, and I think, you know, I don't want to speak for Mr. Solonix or for Paul, but I mean, I've gotten the indication we can handle the flow, but there's a lot other things that we need to make sure, like who's going to maintain the pump stations? Who's going to do that? Who's going to check to make sure? I mean, these are things that, like, I know you're going to say the HOA. I know that's what you're going to say. But, you know, who is that going to be? I mean, we want to make sure we're responsible. And then, you know, again, realizing previously when this wasn't part of it, you know, I think we want to make sure that the Metro Parks, now you're doing it on their road. Previous, you weren't doing this. I know you're doing other stuff on their road, but I would be more comfortable. And I think just to cover all bases so everybody's on the same page here. I mean, for your benefit, I don't want you guys to be blindsided and all of a sudden, and I saw the letter, I believe it was from Sean McDermott. You know, yeah, basically we're okay with this, but, you know, I want to make sure that it's a little bit more spelled out. Okay, yes, we understand that now the sanitary sewer line is going to come down Hawthorne Parkway to Aurora Road.
No, my understanding is that he sent us an email that approved specifically that. That he approved the revised planning and email of...
Larry, I mean, I sort of... You know, he addressed... He had, should be okay predicated on, you know, X, Y, and Z.
Are the Metro Parks building extending the sewer?
No.
After our what?
Are the Metro Parks extending the sewer to their restroom?
You're doing it.
You're going to do it.
They're doing
that. We're extending the sewer to Metro Parks.
Yeah. Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah.
Cleveland Metro Parks is comfortable with a force main and gas route plan. Routing both would occur along Hawthorne Park.
Okay. Yeah, I see that. Mr. Bush, are you John?
I mean, well, as I noted in my memo to the committee, for the city's records, it would be the engineering department's preference to have something a little bit more formal, have a little bit more formal approval than just an email.
We agree with that.
Okay. So if you can get the Metro Park, I mean, this is addressed to John Crawford. This is an address to, you know, I mean, I just, like I say, for everyone's protection, I mean, I think that would be something that, you know, we would like to see, just to make sure that they're...
Just like to keep moving everything rather than stop anything. Keep moving it along, because some of these...
Speaking to the choir.
I understand. Some of these changes, what he wants is he wants the purchase agreement amended. Some of those changes take the drawings that we can't do until we get final approvals on some of the...
I mean, I don't want to speak for the, but, you know, I think basically what you have, we're good with, but now, you know, we've thrown a little bit of a monkey wrench, so, I mean, you have to understand, we want to make sure that, you know, we're checking off all the boxes here with now this new part of, you're going to be coming into ours.
Correct.
At your request.
At our request?
At the city's request, we're moving to there.
I don't know, I thought we just offered when you were having some complications with Bedford Heights.
I think we all agree that this is the best way to go.
Right, now that Metro Parks told us we could go on Hawthorne Parkway, it makes more sense to stay in Solon, because that's where the development is. It makes absolute more sense.
And we're happy to have you.
Absolutely.
I'm sure Mr. Paul would say, you know, like I say, this is fine, but, you know, originally, you know, that wasn't the case. So I think, you know, and I don't want to speak totally for them, but I got the impression that basically we were good with everything. And then there was the hiccup about Oakwood and the flow, and are they going to get, you know, are they going to be able to handle the flow and going through all that? And so then it was, okay, wait a minute, let's maybe step back, go the other alternative once, like you see, the huge thing was getting the okay from the Metro Parks to be able to put
Correct.
That line
yes.
down there. I know one I saw where you're going to try to go through the property, which
right.
would have been extremely difficult. But yeah, like I say, I think you're probably pretty good, but it's just this part that we want to make sure, like I say. And are you doing one or two pump stations now?
One.
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 Is there going to be one to handle the restroom from the Metro Park?
That's not us. The restroom would... John, I don't want to speak for you.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear the question.
The question, is there going to be a separate...
Is there going to be one from the Metro Park to tie into...
The restrooms at the
yes.
south of the development?
There are
yes.
separate
yeah.
yes.
So that's going to be a separate on their dime when they're ready to go. So we're just going to cap off that line going to the south.
Okay. So just so everyone's aware, where my concerns come in is who's responsible when we have a break, when we have those things. And those are the things that I want to make sure we have ironed out, because, you know, when you talk about an HOA maintaining a pump station, people come and go, those responsibilities. No one told me I had to maintain the pump. I had to worry about those type of things. And we've had those type of issues in the past. And ultimately, we're responsible if something happens there and creates a EPA issue, so to speak.
So that exact issue or question is why we're here now and taking this long.
Mm-hmm.
It came up last summer that who was going to be responsible for the line if the HOA defaults.
Right.
And Solon wanted a responsible party. We were going through Oakwood and Cuyahoga County. It was going to take too long for them to come to an agreement with Transcon or Hawthorne Valley. So that's when we decided maybe it would be better to take it to Solon. So now it's my understanding that the HOA will be responsible, and if they do default, that the city of Solon will have the right to go onto the property, make any kind of changes and revisions, and then back charge the HOA.
On their taxes.
And I believe that's...
The owners.
What we talked about with the mayor and the planning commission a while back, right?
John.
But that's still, I think, all being worked out. I'm John.
To that point, and as I noted in my memo mm-hmm. to the committee, with these proposed changes by the applicant, I feel it's necessary for the city public works department and the law department to re-review those covenants to make sure that we're all comfortable with that the maintenance responsibilities are clearly defined, and we'll definitely do that through the process moving forward.
Did you already have that in the covenants?
The covenants, they were revised when we, the last meeting, and given to Lon Stolarski multiple copies for distribution.
Have you seen those, John?
I have reviewed them. In my own opinion, I think there can be some additional edits made to make the make it clearer on kind of what the hierarchy of maintenance is, if you would.
The language that's in there was language we had worked out, but we're very happy to hear from you. Any additional language, just send me an email. But that's what we worked out with Lon in the past. But we can go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, I think they're right. I mean, we had this with other HOAs, especially private. I think we actually have a pump station on a private property. Is, you know, they'll come and they'll be like, what's a pump station? What do you mean? I got to, you know, I just think, you know, and like I say, most people aren't going to understand that and how closely they're going to really read the writing on the wall. I mean, like you say, it's their responsibility.
There will also be money put aside.
Right,
in it.
Right. I understand you're doing that, which
you
that's certainly
that set up in there.
Yeah, that adds to the comfort. John, did you have something else you wanted to say?
To the point of the discussion is, you know, before the original proposal, it was the flow was going outside of the city.
Yeah.
And there was language in there that said that the city wasn't responsible. And for that application, we felt that was fine.
Right.
Now that the direction has changed where it's coming to the city, I feel it's just in the city's best interest to reevaluate those covenants to make sure that we are truly comfortable with everything moving forward.
Okay. Okay, well, maybe you want to get in touch with Lon and just see what, you know, I assume those are more of a legal, right, Mr. Chapman?
I'll be happy to.
But, you know, where we can just make sure that, you know, if we need to add language to that.
Was there anything with the, who was maintaining the Metro Parks portion, that force main, that pump station?
When the one going down to the parking lot?
Yes.
That would all be on the Metro Parks because that's going to be private and totally up to them.
So does that mean we're supposed to?
Pump station. There's also some
to come back. I would think
HOA to deal with it right away.
I'm really confused.
Because the Metro Parks restrooms down at the bottom are also tying into that force main or that pump station, so they're not going to want their backup there either.
And just the concern that it's in the Metro Parks, you know what I mean? So anything that disastrous happens is going to be a public issue at that point.
Right.
So it's touchy. That's all I'm getting at.
So basically, though, what you're saying is, are we going to need to get, and I guess that's, when you're saying the Metro Parks one, that whole lift station, everything, that's pump station, that's separate.
That's separate. That we don't know. They may not put that in. I don't know when they'll put it in.
Okay.
So you know, there's two restrooms that we're talking about.
Right.
There's the one down by the main pump station.
Right.
That's what I was referring to that's going into the.
Okay, that'll be going into, but the one farther down going towards Solon Road.
On Metro Parks.
That's going to, were we aware of that?
Solon Road.
Oh, we were aware of one.
Okay.
And to that point, that's why I think it's critical that the city reevaluate those covenants with everyone, just to make sure that everything is covered. There is no reference of those in the covenants of this secondary force main. And although it may not be party to the HOA, I think it's worthwhile to even have it in there just so that it's, you know, if the question would come up in the future, that it be covered.
We'll have to discuss this outside of this meeting because
that's right.
That becomes a legal issue. That's
I get what
not
you're
us.
Saying. I get what you're
Metro
saying.
Park.
I understand what you're saying.
Understood.
I totally get it.
This is something
we'll just
wanted.
Stay focused on your pump station.
Right.
Okay.
We just had to give them what they wanted so that we...
I get it.
Be able to continue with our development.
I get it. So, yeah, like I say, we'll be happy to move this forward. Well, I don't want to speak for, but,
no,
you know,
fine.
Do you guys have any questions or, you know, we'll be happy to move this forward. One being the referral back to council so that we can amend this 208.
Yes.
Get it back to us. We have to do that. And then we'll just refer it back to planning, you know, kind of based on the engineering memo dated May 3rd.
All right, thank you.
To do that. I mean, just so you know, and maybe Mr. Crawford is, the things that I want to make sure of is, again, and I know you're probably so sick of us saying that, but just is the responsibility of these pump stations. we all have pump stations and developments, you know, throughout the city, you know, that are public and have had issues. I've had issues where there has been a problem, a maintenance problem, gone into the one of my residents' basement. And so I just want to make sure, you know, that we address, you know, me personally, something that I'd like to see addressed is, you know, who's going to maintain them? I know you say the HOA, but that's, you know, I think, and I don't want to speak for you, Paul, I would assume, how often do we inspect, you know, the pump stations that, at least a couple of times a year, or probably every 3 months, or, I mean, I don't know.
Every week we go out to each
every week.
Station.
So he would still be, you'd still be going to this one as well.
Well, that
or no.
It's the HOA, that's what we have to look at. Who's going to be taking care of that? Who's going to
the inspections.
Do the maintenance, do the inspections, make sure that the upkeep's being done on it. Because there's things that creep up that you don't even know. Is there telemetry to let someone know? I mean, those are the things that I'm looking at. So, you know, obviously those are details I'm sure we can work out, but just okay. Those are things that we need to work out.
So, John, are you okay talking then to Paul, like, just to see if we can
sure.
get this figured out? And, you know, like I say, I know this is a private development, but again, these people are going to be residents of this town. So if we could...
And you know, to be honest, the responsibility of it is really between Hawthorne Golf Estates and the city of Sullivan. But I'll provide any information that you need.
Okay, I mean, I think we're willing to help. I mean, I don't want to speak for Paul, but, you know, he may be willing. Hey, I'd be happy to go in and do the inspections for a fee. Is that something you would want to consider adding for the protection of those residents? Because who are they going to get? Once it's built up enough where you guys say, hey, HOA, it's you, and that's how it works, correct, Howard? I mean, once you get enough houses, you go, it's you now. It's you. Who is going to, as a president of an HOA, going to know, I got to get somebody to come out here and inspect this stuff?
With the pump station, you know, we have a certain pumps that we use, correct?
Correct. We try to keep
everything kind of standard.
We spec certain pump manufacturers. So we have about two or three that we try to utilize so we can keep spare pumps, keep things like that on
right.
hand.
So that's a question.
Emergency situations, so... Like I said, there's a lot to the maintenance of the pump station that you have to be concerned about.
So to make sure that the pumps that you guys are putting in over there, are they going to be similar to what we're already using? You know, just, again, those are things that are going to be super critical to so the maintenance is the same on everything. And
yeah, and I saw some correspondence today. John sent me something that someone had requested a standard, and we do have that. So we plan to get that to John and, you know, for your review.
We welcome your review of the plans.
Yeah, well, these will be built to the specs that were given, so that.
Yeah, just for ease of operation and maintenance. Okay, good.
So these are going to be big.
Good, good, good.
Okay,
which is even more concerning. I know that.
Okay, guys. Well, like I say, I'm going to be honest with you. I feel better for these residents, and I'm obviously going to be prejudiced, but that this is coming to Solon. I feel for all. This is Solon.
I think it's best for everybody.
So yeah, I completely. You know, this is. I'm sorry because it's a little bit of a hiccup.
It was a convoluted way to get there, but it is best for everybody.
Yeah,
and the problem was really created because Metro Parks originally.
Right.
We wanted to go like this.
Oh, I'm sure
did
you
not
did.
Want, but then we made the arrangements for the sale of the property, and so they changed their mind.
Okay. Yeah. Well, whatever way it came around. I mean, the sad part is it's kind of causing. You know, a little bit of a delay, but, you know, trust me, we're going to, these guys all know how I feel, and I keep saying, let's get it rolling, but.
We want to do it right.
But, yeah, that being said, like I say, I have to, you know, be out, these are going to be my residents, they're going to be Ward 5 residents, and even if they weren't, and I'm sure, you know, Mike and Bob, I don't want to speak, but they feel the same way, no matter what, you're residents of the town, and we want to make sure that, you know, public or private, that it's going to be done the right way, and these people aren't going to have a lot of headaches. Because that kind of stuff is a big headache. Nobody wants sewer. That's bad. So do you guys want to say anything else? Okay, I'll entertain a motion. So why don't we just make a motion, somebody make a motion to refer this back to council for legislation to amend the 208 plan. Well, you know what? I'll make the motion. Okay, I'm going to make a motion to refer.
That's what she's talking about.
Yeah, right.
Hey, I grew up in a sewer family. What can I say? Okay, I'll go ahead then and make a motion to refer this back to City Council for legislation to amend the 208 plan so that the sanitary sewer comes back to the city of Solon.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Khan?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Okay, and then, I don't think we need to make this, but then we will, and Danette, if you just want to let, that we are going to refer this back to the planning department and, you know, kind of based on the engineering memo dated May 3rd, 2023. Okay, all right, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's keep it going. I have so many residents that are just chomping at the bit to get in there. All right, thank you, gentlemen. Have a good evening. Okay. So item number three is the Hawthorne Golf Estate subdivision revised preliminary plat and 208 area-wide water quality community management plan, facility planning, area modification. I sort of think we've, John, is there anything more you wanted to cover with us? Now that I've already made the motion and let them leave.
I think we've covered it.
We've covered it. Okay, perfect. Okay. Moving on to new then, item number four, the storm response status update. Hello, Dennis.
Hello. How's everybody doing tonight?
Dennis.
Thanks.
Good. My recording date for this is 3:20 to 4:19. At this time, we had 4.09 inches of rain. All of our flood control was taken care of. We had 13 combined storm and sanitary sewer calls, one of which was a city issue. It was a root cutting job that we had. Otherwise, it was all private property issues. Our storm truck for this month, we had on Miles Road, we had the water break. That was fantastic for everybody. All the catch basins were pretty much filled up in there. So our guys were out cleaning the catch basins up there. Station Street, another water break. Same deal, cleaning the catch basins from debris over there. On Parkside Trail, we had a catch basin that was deteriorated, and this has been put on the engineer's repair list. We had some road flooding up there, so that was all cleaned up and is currently functioning, but it's going to get repaired here sooner than later. Had some road flooding on Cruzy Drive. Basin was full of debris and got that taken care of. On Harper Road at Cannon, the church there on the corner did some hydro excavation for a gas line for the engineering department, and still been doing our pre-cleaning for our TV crew for the concrete annual. So you guys have been pretty busy. Our excavation crew, we had four hydrants repaired for the fire department hydrant repair program. And on Longview, resident called in a sinkhole. They had a yard drain that was not tied in that made a heck of a sinkhole. We got that tied in. If I can have the document camera, please. This is the back side of the catch basin. This white part here is her lateral from the in between the yards. And it was just basically deadheaded back there. So the whole area was swamp. We hydro-excavated around and cored into the back of the basin. And they no longer have problems with flooding in the rear yard. So worked out pretty well. Our sanitary truck this month, busy month for them. They had 12 pump stations that were cleaned. They assisted our TV crew with the pre-cleaning as well as the storm truck for the concrete annual. And they had three sanitary work orders completed. TV truck, they've been doing all the inspections for any sort of issues for the concrete program. On spatter dock, we found a series of sinkholes. Dye was observed in the storm main. This will have to be put on our grout list. Pettibone Road, we located a storm lateral for the engineering department. And on Liberty, located another storm lateral for the engineering department. So, picking up.
Seeing you're busy.
Can answer any questions at this time.
I do have a real quick one, because I kind of hear complaints about this, is when it rains a lot, it seems to always kind of water pools right over here, right on Somm by like the marks, and is that?
Sort of very large basins, but I don't know if it's maybe kind of like the groove in the road a little bit, it might have an issue there.
Okay. It just, I don't know if any of you guys have ever noticed that, but if it really starts to rain a lot, there always seems to be kind of some pooling in that right lane on Somm, and I've been meaning to ask you, like, is there anything we can do about that?
There's some pretty big inlet basins there that could really take a lot of water.
Could take it. So it's just, sometimes storms just hit the...
Sometimes they just hit a little different and...
Okay, it just pools. John, did you want to make some comment about that?
I don't think the issue is with the storm source, because the last time we resurfaced
Somm,
we rebuilt a bunch of those in that area. I think just generally in that area by the intersection, I drive that way every time, every day, and I notice it when it rains. I think it generally flows, but the elevation, it's very flat through there. So when you do get situations where you get a lot of heavy rain, it will tend to pool up. But it does ultimately drain away.
Okay. So that's just something, you know, it just happens, and it's okay. All right. Well, thank you. Any other questions for Dennis from the committee? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Moving to item number 5, the 2023 Infrastructure Improvement Program Monthly Update. John.
Good evening. How's the committee?
Doing well. Thanks.
All right. To update the committee from last month's update, under our priority one projects, the painting of the miscellaneous traffic signal equipment project that was awarded, moving down into our priority twos, we had expenditures from our emergency and miscellaneous roadway repairs, and then moving down into our priority threes, we awarded the construction inspection last month, as well as we had updates for the design services. We had expenditures for our traffic engineering services and updates to the engineering chargebacks, and the materials testing was awarded. If there's any questions from the committee, I can address those now.
Okay. Any questions? No. Thank you, John. Nope. Okay, moving to item number 6, inspection and maintenance agreement 6372, Somm Center LLC City Barbecue located at 6372 Somm Center Road.
Yes, so as part of the City Barbecue's stormwater management system that's built in accordance with our certified codified ordinance 1257. They're required to have a post-construction management agreement, which is attached for the committee's consideration. We've reviewed this with the law department and are requesting that legislation be prepared authorizing the mayor to execute the agreement between the City of Solon and 6372 Somm Center, Somm LLC, also known as City Barbecue.
Any questions from the committee? I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion that legislation be prepared authorizing the mayor to execute the inspection and maintenance agreement for stormwater control measures between 6372 Somm LLC City Barbecue and the City of Solon.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Kahn?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to item number 7, post-construction inspection and maintenance agreement, Chabad Jewish Center of Solon, 5570 Harper Road.
Okay, similarly to the previous agenda item, this is a post-construction inspection and maintenance agreement for the Chabad Jewish Center at 5570 Harper Road. And the engineering department requests legislation be prepared authorizing the mayor to execute the agreement between the City of Solon and the Chabad Jewish Center of Solon.
Any questions from the committee? I'll entertain a motion.
I make a motion to have legislation prepared authorizing the mayor to execute the agreement between the Chabad Jewish Center located at 5570 Harper Road and the City of Solon for the post-construct inspection and maintenance agreement.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Khan?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to item number 8, the 2023 Annual Catch Basin Repair Program. Contract 2023.04, bid tabulation.
Yes, so on April 14th, the city opened 3 bids for the 2023 Annual Catch Basin Repair Program. The apparent low bidder was Construction King in the amount of $209,403. The engineer's estimate was $200,000. And the detailed bid tabulation, which has been checked by the Finance Department, is attached for the committee's consideration. Although the estimate or the bid of Construction King is over the engineer's estimate, it is still awardable since it's within the 10% criteria. We did not check their references as the city just recently awarded the 2023 concrete repair program to them, at which time we did check their references. So the engineering department requests that legislation be prepared awarding the 2023 annual catch basin repair program to Construction King as the lowest and best bidder under emergency so that we could begin construction as soon as possible in the amount of $209,403.
And we were happy with them, right?
Yes.
They did. Okay, any questions from the committee? I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion that legislation be prepared awarding the 2023 annual catch basin repair program contract 2023.04 to Construction King as the lowest and best bidder under emergency in order to begin construction as soon as possible in the amount of $209,403.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Khan?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to item number 9, Water Reclamation Facility Clarifier Painting Project, contract 2021.20. Final change order.
Good evening.
Hi, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Hello. So this is a final change order for our water reclamation clarifier painting project, contract number 2021.20. The original contract amount was for $185,000 and an original completion date of 8/25/22. The project was completed on time. We had $185,000 in there. $5,000 was for contingency money, which we did not need. There were no change orders, so hence the final contract amount is $180,000. We supplied a breakdown of the final contract amount, and the contractor evaluation are attached. If the committee remembers, this was one of those deals that the contractor probably left roughly $150,000 on a table, and we were hesitant to go forward with this project, and I guess all said and done, I probably would have went the other way. We really saved a considerable amount of money, but it was also quite a hassle. The contractor had never done anything probably to this magnitude, right. Although, you know, all the references said they were good, but we got the job done. They contested some of the project. Virtually, they thought that they were owed some extra money for change order work, which we contested with our legal team, and okay. Finally came to the conclusion of where we're at today, okay. Which is just the original contract amount. Mm-hmm. So that's part of the reason why we're asking to perform this on emergency, to pass this on emergency so we can get this moved and paid for.
Gotcha. Okay. Okay, yeah, it sounds, yeah, the... sounds like they weren't the greatest when you look at the...
Yes.
But what they did was obviously...
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
That's the important part. Okay. Any other questions from the committee? I'll entertain a motion.
Make a motion to have legislation prepared approving this final change order for the Water Reclamation Facility Clarifier Painting Project. Close out the contract in the amount of $180,000 and declaring an emergency.
Second.
Okay. I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Khan?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Paul.
Thank you.
Thanks, Paul.
Okay, moving on to item number 10, request legislation be prepared for the authorization to extend and renew the previously approved contract, Ordinance 2020-143, with the Kimball Company for the processing of the recycling materials for the option year. And even though on our, it says one, we want to sort of amend that to say option year two. October 1st, 2023 to September 30th, 2024. Hello, Mark.
Hello, everyone. Hope everyone's doing okay.
Hi, Mark.
Yes, back in 2020, I brought to the committee this before for the acceptance to go into contract with Kimball Recycling for the disposal and processing of our recycling that we collect. This contract is through the Cuyahoga County Consortium, as we often partner with that. The contract was for 2 years with two additional options to renew. So the reason I'm here tonight is the first option, which we picked up last year, is set to expire in September, on September 30th of this year. And I'm requesting legislation to move forward with the option 2 year for this contract. This will give us a fixed pricing and guarantee that we will have a locked in price for the next year. And then next year, the county is in the process of going out to bid for the next set of terms for these services. So, but services requesting to have legislation be prepared under emergency to authorize and accept the second 1 year option renewal for the contract year of October 1, 2023 to September 30th of 2024 with the Kimball Company to avoid any disruptions with the service and to lock in the contract pricing.
And is the contract price basically the same, Mark?
For recycling, it went up to, we went from $73.20 a ton to $76.13. Yes, unfortunately, it was something that we used to get money back,
broke even,
and now it's, but they're looking at a couple different options, especially for recycling, fair market sharing, and options where the processor pays part with the, you know, the municipality, so. But I will be bringing that forward as soon as we get the terms from that.
Okay. Yeah, like I say, it's what a different world from a number of years ago when, like you say, we used to get paid for recycling. But hopefully somebody can figure it out because I think it's important for, you know,
of course,
our earth. And, you know, if we can do that the best. Any other questions from the committee? Okay, I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion that legislation be prepared under emergency to authorize and accept this, excuse me, the second 1 year renewal option with the Kimball Company for the contract year of October 1st, 2023 to September 30th, 2024 under emergency to avoid any disruptions to the service.
You just say option year two, right?
Option year two, correct.
Okay.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Khan?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to item number 11, requesting legislation be prepared for the authorization to extend and renew the previously approved contract, Ordinance 2020-142, with Browning Ferris Industries of Ohio, Inc., doing business as Republic Service, Inc., for the disposal of solid waste services for the option year two of October 1st, 2023 to September 30th, 2024.
Yes, this is just like the counterpart to the recycling. This is for our solid waste disposal through Republic. And again, service is just requesting legislation be prepared under emergency to authorize and accept the second 1 year option with Republic Services for the disposal of solid waste for the city to avoid any disruptions with service and lock in the contract price for the contract year of October 1, 2023 to September 30th of 2024.
Any questions from the committee? I entertain a motion.
Make a motion to have legislation prepared under emergency to authorize and accept the 1 year, the second 1 year renewal option with Republic Services Incorporated for the contract year of October 1st, 2023 to September 30th, 2024 to avoid any disruptions of service.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Khan?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to item number 12, requesting authorization to accept the State of Ohio DAS contract number RS900619, extension to purchase fuel and to allow the city to continue to use this contract for the full extent of the contract term until June 30th, 2024.
Yes, this is another one of the big ones that we have to secure here. But back in 2018, under ordinance 2018-143, the city authorized the service to move forward with the contract through the DAS for purchase of fuel products. That original contract was for 3 years with 2 one-year options. Given the current environment and climate we live in, I reached out to the state, and they had ensured me that they were going to add an additional year to the current contract, which is RS900619. And that was something that the state confirmed, and I did verify that with our vendor, Great Lakes Petroleum. So what I'm asking is legislation be prepared under emergency to accept the additional one-year extension to State of Ohio DAS contract RS900619 to allow the city to continue to purchase fuel using this contract and to avoid any issues with our service of providing fuel for all the departments.
Okay, any questions from the committee? I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion that legislation be prepared under emergency to accept the one-year extension of the State of Ohio DAS contract number RS900619 to purchase fuel and to allow the city to continue to use this contract for the full extent of the contract term until June 30th, 2024.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Khan?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Mark.
Moving to projects and reports, item number 13, Engineering Department Study Design Report.
The committee has my report, and I'd be happy to answer any questions you may have.
Any questions for...
not at the moment.
Well, and I don't know whether John or Dan, even though this isn't us doing it, obviously it affects a lot of our residents, the Dominion work on Solon Road, any idea of what the timetable on that? Like when they think they're going to be done, or look at you both laughing.
According to the gas company and the contractor's schedule, their work should be done on June 19th is the completion date for their project. They just completed boring under the road, and they're starting to get into the portion where they're going to start open cut trenches for installation of gas mains and pavement restoration that'll follow behind that.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Well, it looks like in a couple of days the weather's going to be improving, so.
Yes.
Let's hope, Bob.
And then we do Solon Road, right?
This is the project we've been waiting for, so yes, Solon Road would be up for bid as soon as this is done. I don't anticipate on constructing it yet this year. Obviously, there won't be enough time to finish it if we would start it yet this year. But at the very least, if we're able to, I'd still like to try to bid it out at least so that we could have it ready for construction for next season.
Very good. Okay, thanks.
Great. Mike?
Hi, John. Wondering how much the rebidding of Aurora Road, how much it affects the timeline, you think, in terms of the construction?
Time-wise, it probably just affects the time frame of the bidding. There was still going to be long lead times for materials and from water line to precast structures. And utility relocation. And unfortunately, with the utility relocation, we're kind of at the mercy of the weather. The first utility to do the relocation is the illuminating company, so that you know, a lot of the other utilities attach to their poles, so they can't do their work till the new poles are installed. As you recall, a few weeks back we had quite a bit of rain and wind and weather that caused a lot of power outages. Unfortunately, that drew the illuminating company off of our project to address more concerning issues. So there was a period of time, probably 2 or 3 weeks, where minimal work was happening on our project for good reason.
Great.
Any other questions for John? Thank you, John. Okay, moving on to item 14, construction report, May 3rd, 2023. Hello, Dan.
Hello, everyone. As you can see from the supplemental inspection report that we used $7,970 for inspection services last month with contracts from last year getting buttoned up and that sort of thing. Punch list work getting accomplished finally, which is great. So we've started using that contract, but there's plenty of money left there to finish the month is what we have to do on that one. And on the emergency road repair, I think I mentioned to you last month that we had that Miles Road water break that wasn't on my report last month. And it, the repair of the pavement there was $23,210.84, which leaves us with a balance of $383,418. Be happy to answer any other questions.
I don't want to hear the word Miles Road water break, but besides that, you know, and again, and I know I ask this all the time, Dan, how much, I mean, we obviously recoup something from Cleveland Water for
we
this.
We will, when we submit our reimbursement, we have to honestly wait for their request and then submit the reimbursement. Okay. It's a process, and what we get is the minimal that they'll give us for the small opening that they make in the in the pavement, and not necessarily all of the pavement and other infrastructure we have that's damaged because of the water break.
Seriously, they only pay for just like where they think it just
the rules are pretty well set, and the city of Solon,
but they had a good lawyer, didn't they,
10 years ago.
Wow. Okay, that is what it is. But like I said, I don't want to hear that word, Miles Road water break. Mike.
Staying on Miles Road, but not related to that, with the wall, I did get a question about from a resident about the landscaping surrounding the wall. Is that something that Trimore will refit, or is that something the city will take care of regarding the landscaping around the wall?
It's part of their contract to do the restoration that of all the damage that was caused by their work. Basically, there's no special landscaping plan for the area, but the grass will be restored as well as the pavement cleaned up and all of that sort of thing.
Thanks.
Okay, you're welcome.
All right, any questions?
No, I'm good.
All right, thank you, Dan.
You're welcome.
Okay, moving on to item 15, the sanitary and storm report.
Yes, we're currently in the process of buttoning up this contract, making final payments, and I have no other changes at this time. Can you answer any questions?
Okay. Any questions? Okay. Nope. Thank you. Yep. Okay. Moving then on to the item 16, the March 2023 progress and financial reports. I guess that'd be you, Paul.
Is that me?
Yeah, I'm not sure why it's written that way. I'm thought, isn't this water?
Doesn't sound like it came out right.
Okay,
it wasn't what
the
I
water
was
reclamation
expecting.
Reports.
Just a construction update. So the contractor's continuing to work. When we did have the break in the weather, he was working outside, starting to work on the primary building hatch work, cutting out the concrete for that, and working on the curbing around the building. Also was doing the same thing in secondary, working on the hatch work there, and working on the curbing around the building. He's kind of demoed all that, and they've poured some of the outside concrete work.
Right.
Kind of holding off on the inside of the solids building until the weather breaks,
right,
or until he gets rainy weather, which
sure.
He'll be moving back inside for that. Then he'll be moving on to the trickling tower. So his concentration right now is while he's got weather is to do the outside work, and then come back and do the inside work too. So they're probably going to be stepping it up because the solids building work has taken a lot longer than they thought. So they might be getting some more help to kind of speed things up a little bit and get a lot more going on all around the plant. So it's a little difficult to maneuver around the plant because we got everything torn up
sure
right
I
now.
Got.
So it's a little difficult to operate. As the committee is aware, I brought the screw pump and trickling filter arm design work. Lo and behold, today they just told me that one of the flights broke on the screw pumps. So, you know, I've been holding that project off because I didn't want to have two things be right in the middle of two big projects.
Right.
And the concrete project is because it, you know, took so long to get off the ground, kind of put us in this predicament. But we'll look at that tomorrow and see what happened. But it just, as luck would have it, you know, as soon as we start
wow.
the design work, that one of them goes. So hopefully we can do some temporary repairs
okay.
So we can at least limb through because they're hoping to be able to go out to bid at the end of the year.
Right. Okay.
They've already came out and did a preliminary walk around to see what they need to address.
But in the meantime, we'll have to see if we can do something to make that repair, and I'm not sure what that's going to entail.
All right, well, let us know if you need anything.
So it was definitely needed, obviously.
Yeah, the timing was good.
Yeah. And just to bring the committee up to date on our toxicity, this is probably, we're a year and a month into doing our extra investigation into the toxicity. We've hired EnviroScience to do the testing for us.
Right.
We had one hit early on, probably about a year ago, that we had toxicity. Unfortunately, they didn't find anything in the lines.
Okay.
So our next test is coming up here in June. We contracted with them for another year. I think we put aside about $30,000 for testing.
Okay.
To try to see if we can still find something, and we have not found it yet. So again, our whole purpose to do this is because if we don't find what it is, the EPA could mandate us to do something. It could potentially be a lot of money.
Okay.
So we're hoping that what we're trying to do ahead of time will buy us some leeway when the renewal of the next permit comes up, which is in 2025. So we virtually, hopefully within the next year, we can find something, at least get something to go on. But it's really like trying to find a needle in a haystack. You know, we're setting samples out. We're collecting samples out in the areas that we believe are problems. And hopefully if we get a toxicity hit at the plant, we can go back to those samples and see if there's something in there.
Gotcha.
And try to correlate that. Okay. So that's our goal. And not that I want to see it happen, but if it does, I would like to see something in the sewer line that might indicate that we have a problem out there in the collection system.
Oh boy.
So we'll continue to investigate.
Yeah. Well, thanks for the update. We'll keep our fingers crossed that, like you say, have you ever had that happen before, Paul, that something showed and you did?
This is the first time that we've had the toxicity test, and
okay,
because it showed up, it started showing up regularly. We used to only have to do it once a year,
okay,
the toxicity test. Since when our new permit came out, the EPA, obviously, they review our records and say,
sure,
okay, you've had toxicity. We're going to up your sampling
okay,
you know, to quarterly, and of course, then your likelihood of having it happen is, you know, increased.
Increases, sure. Okay.
So, and that's virtually what's going to happen. If we don't find something, then
yeah,
who knows what the next step will be from there.
We don't want to even go there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thanks, Paul. Any
mm-hmm
questions for Paul from the committee? Okay, thank you. Okay, moving on to item 17, the Service Department Monthly Report. Hello, Mark.
Hello. The committee has my report for the month, and I can answer any questions at this time.
Well, I sure know you guys have been busy with the trees.
Yes. Yeah, we had quite a few hazard trees, either the crews at service handled or we took care of through our hazard storm contract.
But I'm talking about people putting limbs out on the tree lawn.
Oh, yes.
Oh,
yes.
Lord.
Brush is in full effect. We are out, though. We have been working, you know, a little over during the week. But it is that time of year, so we just ask everybody to, you know, be patient first off and to check our website for our locations where we've worked and where we're going to be, too. So.
Yeah, some of them. And I think it's important because I think, you know, tell me if I'm wrong. If you have a tree service come out to your home, you can't be putting it out. I mean, the preference is that they take care of it, not that you put it. Is that
correct?
Still,
yeah.
Okay.
Any landscaper or tree company or anybody
okay
doing contract work for you is responsible for that.
Right.
Where it's hard for us is we have to catch the people in the act.
Right.
Gotcha. All too often, you know, we see the after effects.
Yeah.
But yeah, our service is more for incidental brush throughout the yard, not tree removals.
Yeah, I mean, I saw some like unbelievably huge piles. It was just like mind-boggling. Like, oh my goodness, like it was covering the whole yard. It was
yeah
just amazing. So residents, please, you know, don't take advantage, because I'm sure just for the time, I can't even imagine how long it took the crews to even clean up that just one yard.
It's we've been around 3 to 4 weeks to make it one pass through the city.
Wow.
Which this time of year it's expected, but it's a little bit heavier than normal just because of the past windstorms and that.
Yeah, gotcha. Okay, anybody else have any questions for? Okay, thank you, Mark. Okay, where are we at here? Let me go back. Okay, so we're down to correspondence. We have none, so I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Mr. Kahn?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schimmitz?
Yes.